Hello everyone, welcome back to a new Vectornator Academy video. This is the second video of our Getting Started interface series, and today we're talking about the inspector. The inspector is divided into five different tabs. Let's go through them one by one. First, we have the Style tab. That allows you to define or change the color of any selected object. Here you can access the color picker to change the fill or the stroke of your shape. Apart from that, you can also change any arrowhead or play with the blend modes. Second on the list is the Arrange tab, which will be very useful for controlling the position of your object. You can rotate it in virtually any direction you want, or flip it horizontally or vertically. This tab also allows you to group or ungroup different shapes. I'm just going to select these objects here, and then I am simply going to tap on Group. And you can align various objects as well. I'm selecting these little circles and the line, and I'm aligning them on the vertical axis. Moving on to the Path tab. This is where all your Boolean operations are, the masking function, as well as the options to add or delete anchor points. The next tab is the Layer tab. Here you see all the layers you created. By tapping this arrow, you can expand the list of all the elements on your layer. The little lock symbol will lock or unlock your layer, while the eye symbol is useful for hiding or revealing layers and objects. A bonus tip, if you activate the Isolate Active Layer mode, then you will only be able to see the elements that are placed on the particular layer that is selected. Okay, let's deactivate that. Lastly, we have the Library tab, which contains five different subtabs. Templates will give you access to all of your templates, as well as pre-existing libraries. For example, the iOS library contains some very useful assets that are needed for iOS UI design. But you can also access your photo gallery or SF symbols. To add a symbol to your canvas, simply drag and drop it. Next, the Iconator subtab gives you access to a library of over 80,000 icons, easy to search and find. For example, let's look for some moon icons. So many good options to choose from. All right, now the last tab takes you directly to Unsplash. In case you didn't know, they're a platform that offers tens of thousands of beautiful free photos. If I search moon again, I get all these awesome results. Import by tapping on the image or by drag and drop. And that is it for the inspector. Thanks for watching, everyone. See you in our next video.